In the previous period, we were discussing about remainder theorem, that when we say that a given polynomial is divided by the another polynomial, how to find the remainder? We can use remainder theorem to find out the remainder instead of doing it by using long division method, right? Long division method ki bajaye aap remainder theorem use kar sakte ho. So we discuss it in the previous period. Let us start with its application, and let us start with certain questions based on remainder theorem. First question I'm taking. You are having a polynomial, namely Px is equal to x cube minus 5x square plus 3x plus 1. Find remainder when it is divided by x minus 1. x minus 1 by 3 से ये divide हो, हमने इस केस में remainder जो है वो find करना है. So you know how to find the remainder? We learned right now that to find the remainder, whatever is the divisor, that is to be equated to be zero, to equal to zero. So from here you will get the value of the variable. So you will write, according to remainder theorem, remainder is equal to P of 1 by 3. So in place of x, replace 1 by 3. In place of x, replace 1 by 3. According to remainder theorem, remainder will be P of 1 of 3. So in place of x, you have to replace it by 1 by 3. So solving it, this is 1 by 27 plus minus 5 by 9 plus 3 get cancelled. This is 1 plus 1. So this is equal to 1 by 27 minus 5 by 9 plus 2. So we are taking LCM. 27 will be the LCM. Right, so this will be 1 minus 9 threes are 3 fives are 15 27 twos are 54. So this is minus 14 plus 54 upon 27. So 44 upon 27 will be the value of the remainder when the given polynomial is divided by the another polynomial. Minus 14 plus 54. 14. यहाँ पे 40 आएगा. 40 upon 27. So this is the way to find the remainder when a given polynomial is given. A polynomial is given and it is divided by the another polynomial. नेक्स्ट देखो, फाइंड द रिमाइंडर व्हेन द पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स इज इक्वल टू 4x³ प्लस 8x² माइनस 17x प्लस 10 इज डिवाइडेड बाय द पॉलिनोमियल 2x माइनस 1 इज डिवाइडेड बाय द अनदर पॉलिनोमियल 2x minus 1. Find the remainder when this polynomial, it is divided by the another polynomial 2x minus 1. So what the way? So first of all, whatever is the divisor, that is to be equated to 0. And from here, you will get x. So x comes out to be 1 by 2. So according to remainder theorem, remainder is equal to P of 1 by 2. And that is equal to 4, 1 by 2 cube plus 8. 1 by 2 square minus 17 into 1 by 2 plus 10. So that is equal to 4 into 1 by 8 plus 8 into 1 by 4 minus 17 by 2 plus 10. So this is equal to 1 by 2 plus 2 कटिंग कर दो इसकी, 1/2 + 2 - 17/2 + 10, सो वी आर टेकिंग एलसीएम, 2 इज द एलसीएम, ठीक है. सो सॉल्विंग इट फर्दर, दिस इज 1 + 4 - 17 + 20, सो दिस इज 5 - 17 + 20/2, दिस इज -12 + 20/2, दिस इज इक्वल टू 8/2, एंड द आंसर इज 4. दिस इज ऑल द गेम ऑफ कैलकुलेशंस इफ यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट. कॉन्सेप्ट आपको अगर पता है कि दैट व्हेन वी आर डिवाइडिंग इट द पॉलीनोमियल एंड द रिमाइंडर इज अकॉर्डिंगली पुटिंग द डिवाइजर इक्वल टू 0, गेटिंग द वेरिएबल एंड पुटिंग इट दैट, देन द रेस्ट इज द गेम ऑफ कैलकुलेशंस, दैट हाउ यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग इट केयरफुली, राइट. सो दिस इज द आंसर. Now the question is, when the questions based on remainder theorem, they are having some different language, then the students, they got confused. So let us discuss that how these questions can be asked in the different ways. Questions based on the remainder theorem, how they can be asked in the different ways. For example, I'm taking first question. Find k if x^51 + 2x^60 + 3x + k divisible by x + 1. Find k if this is divisible by x + 1. Find k if x^51 + 2x^60 + 3x + k is divisible by x + 1. See, so you know this question is based on remainder theorem. First of all, यही मैं आपको बता रही हूँ कि कुछ questions ऐसे होंगे जिनकी application करते time आपको ये खुद realize करना है that this is application of remainder theorem. Find k if this is divisible by x + 1. If I say that 56 is exactly divisible by 2, then definitely remainder comes out to be 0. Similarly, if this polynomial is definitely divisible by x + 1, that means when we will divide the polynomial by x + 1, remainder is going to be 0. First of all, we are naming this polynomial px. This is x^51 + 2x^60 + 3x + k. As px is exactly divisible by x + 1, so putting x + 1 = 0, that is x = -1, therefore remainder is equal to zero. As px is exactly divisible by the polynomial x + 1, so when we will divide px by x + 1, remainder is equal to 0. This is the concept that you have to remember, right? So remainder equal to 0, that means p of -1 = 0. Now replacing x by -1 in the given polynomial, you will be having -1 / 51 plus 2 × -1 / 60 plus 3 × -1 plus k equal to 0. ठीक है, तो आपने x की जगह पे -1 यहाँ पे पुट कर दिया. सो -1 / odd power = -1 - 1 / even power = even number -3 + k = 0. सो -1 + 2 - 3 + k, this is equal to 0. So this is 1 - 3 + k = 0. Rest are the calculations. -2 + k = 0. So k is equal to 2. This is the answer. K ki value hamare paas 2 aa gayi. Right? So indirectly, this is the application of the remainder theorem, that this polynomial is divided divisible by the another polynomial. Indirectly, it means that remainder is equal to zero. So using the condition that remainder is equal to zero, solving it, you will get the value of the unknown, that is k here. Right? Just say one more language you can say can be used for the same application. I'm doing the next question. Check whether the polynomial qt is equal to 4t cube plus 4t square minus t minus 1 is a multiple of 2t plus 1 or not. This time, pichli baar usne bola tha exactly divisible by. This time he says multiple of this. If 72 is multiple of 2, then when we will divide this 72 by 2, the remainder will be 0. If 51 is multiple of 3, when we divide this 51 by 3, the remainder is 0. We know this. So multiple ka matlab hi ek tarah se kehne ka yahi hai, that when we are doing the division, remainder comes out to be zero. That is the concept of the multiple. So as this is multiple of this, therefore remainder is equal to zero. Remainder on dividing this polynomial by the another polynomial, this will be equal to zero, as the given polynomial is the multiple of the another polynomial. Right? So this is 2t plus 1, equate kar do isko. 2t plus 1 equal to 0. So you will get t equal to minus 1 by 2. So q of minus 1 by 2. Ek minute. Check karna hai ki multiple hai ya nahi. Sorry. We have to check the whether it is multiple or not. So iska matlab we have to find the remainder. Hum remainder find karenge. If the remainder comes out to be zero, then the given polynomial is multiple of the another polynomial. And if the remainder is not coming out to be zero, then the given polynomial is not the remainder of the another polynomial. So hume isko check karna hai remainder hai ki nahi. Q of minus 2, matlab hume remainder find karna hai. Q of minus 1 by 2 put kiya humne, plus 4 into minus 1 by 2 square minus minus 1 by 2 minus 1. So further this is equal to 4 into minus 1 by 8 plus 4 into 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 minus 1. So this is minus 4 by 8 plus 4 by 4 plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Ye kate, plus 1 minus 1 kata, plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 kata. Answer 0 aagaya. That means remainder comes out to be 0. And when remainder comes out to be 0, it is but obvious that this polynomial is, sorry, this polynomial is multiple of the another polynomial. So language can be used. The change, it can be asked like this, that check whether it is multiple of not, then even then it is application of remainder theorem. You need to find remainder and then you have to comment according to the value of the remainder. If remainder is zero, then the given polynomial is a multiple of the other polynomial. If the remainder is not zero, then it's not so, right? The another you can say language that right now we have used, that the given polynomial is divisible by the another polynomial. Again, the application of remainder theorem. When it is divisible by the another polynomial, that means remainder equal to zero and accordingly. Jab jab divisible hai, to remainder zero ke equal hai. Okay, let us do one or two questions based on the application of remainder theorem, finding the unknown. If the polynomial if the polynomial ax cube plus 3x square plus 5x minus 4 and x cube minus 4x plus a leaves the same remainder. Leaves the same remainder when divided by x minus 2. Find a. This condition is given that when this polynomial and this polynomial, that means two polynomials are given, and for these two polynomials, condition is given that when these two polynomials are divided by x minus 2, the remainder is the same. So according to question, हम इन पॉलिनोमियल्स को डिफरेंटली नेमिंग कर लेते हैं. सपोज द फर्स्ट पॉलिनोमियल आई एम नेमिंग इट एज पी एक्स ए एक्स क्यूब प्लस थ्री एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव एक्स माइनस फोर. दिस इज पी एक्स. फर्स्ट पॉलिनोमियल आई एम टेकिंग टू बी पी एक्स. सेकेंड पॉलिनोमियल आई कैन नेम इट एज क्यू एक्स, दैट इज एक्स क्यूब माइनस फोर एक्स प्लस ए. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन, when this polynomial px is divided by x minus 2, the remainder comes out to be, when this polynomial qx is divided by x minus 2, remainder comes out to be, both the remainders are zero. So isko hum zero ke equal put karte hain, this is equal to 2. So the remainder when this is divided by px is p of 2 and divided by qx is q of, according to question, p of 2 is equal to q of 2. Both the remainders, they are equal. So putting the values, एक्स की जगह पे टू पुट कर दो. ऑन द अदर हैंड इधर एक्स की जगह पे टू, दिस इज ए. रिप्लेसिंग एक्स बाय टू, दिस विल बी एट ए ट्वेल्व टेन माइनस फोर, दिस इज एट माइनस एट प्लस ए. Rest is the game of calculations. Minus 8 plus 8 cancel. 22 minus 4. is equal to A. 8A plus 18 is equal to A. So further it is equal to 8a minus a is equal to minus 18. So 7a is equal to minus 18. So a is equal to minus 18 upon 7. This is the answer. This is another application of remainder theorem, in which we see that the two polynomials, they are leaving the same remainder when divisible by the common polynomial, using the condition where we can get the value of the unknown. Right? Next, polynomials bx cube 3x square minus 3 and 2x cube minus 5x plus b when divided by x minus 4. This is leaving remainder R1 and this is leaving remainder R2, such that 2R1 minus R2 equal to 0. Then using this condition, find B. Using this condition, find B. This polynomial, first polynomial, when it is divided by x minus 4, it is leaving remainder R1. And the second polynomial, when it is divided by x minus 4, it is leaving remainder R2. Condition, the relation between R1 and R2 is given, that 2R1 minus R2 is equal to 0. Using this relation, we have to find the value of B. Right? Let us see. Naming of the polynomial is must. Both are the different polynomial, but in the same variable, So I can name them as px and qx. So px is bx cube plus 3x square minus 3, and qx is 2x cube minus 5x plus b. ये हमारे पास px and qx हो गए. Divided by x minus 4, px is leaving remainder r1. Divided by x minus 4, px is leaving remainder r1. So वैसे अगर हम x minus 4 के remainder के लिए check करना हो, we have to put x is equal to 4. That means according to question, p of 4, this is equal to r1. According to question. So p of 4, that means b into 4 cube, 3 into 4 square minus 3, this is equal to r1. 64b, 48 minus 3 is equal to r1. 64b plus 45, this is equal to r1. ये आपके पास r1 की वैल्यू आ गई. जो qx है, when it is divided x minus, divided by x minus 4, it is leaving the remainder r2. ये remainder कौन सा छोड़ रहा है? r2. So इसका मतलब q of 4, this is equal to r2. q of 4, this is equal to r2. Put करें जरा value, x की जगह पे 4, 2 into 4 cube minus 5 into 4 plus b, this is equal to r2. Minus 20 plus b equal to r2. That means 108 plus b, this is equal to r2. ये हमारी r2 की वैल्यू आ गई using the given conditions. Now we will use the relation between r1 and r2, that is 2r1 minus r2 equal to 0. So this is 2r1 minus r2 equal to 0. Putting the values, this is 2. Value of r1 is 64b plus 45 minus value of r2 is 108 plus b equal to 0. Now we will solve it and we'll get b. Multiply, 2 will go inside. This will be 128b plus 9b minus 108 minus b equal to 0. So 127b, b wali terms combine hogi and constants they will be combined. So 108 minus 90 minus 18. So 127b equal to 18. So b is equal to 18 upon 127. So this is the value of B. चलिए, so ये हुई हमारी remainder theorem की application. कि remainder theorem से related questions हमें किस तरह के आ सकते हैं, right? The language for such kind of questions can be used like the first polynomial is exactly divisible by the another polynomial, then the remainder is zero. It can be like check whether the first polynomial is multiple of the second polynomial or not. Again, we need to find remainder and so on, right? So this is all about remainder theorem. Let us consider, let us start with the next. That is, achha, remainder theorem mein factor theorem agla aa jana hai factorization. Next is factor theorem. Factor theorem is very much linked with the remainder theorem. काफी हद तक जो factor theorem है वो remainder theorem के साथ linked है. कैसे linked है? Let me tell you. Suppose we have to check that this is a polynomial px, and we say that x minus a will be its factor, When we say that two is factor of 72. Why we say this? Because we know that when we will divide 72 by 2, the remainder is equal to 0. Similarly, he says x minus a will be factor of px if remainder is equal to zero, that means remainder इसका निकालें p of a equal to zero. So x minus a factor होगा तब जब p of a equal to zero होगा. X minus a will be factor if p of a is equal to zero. X minus a will be factor of px if p of a equal to zero. Remainder is equal to zero. That means indirectly factor theorem is again the application of remainder theorem. To check whether the given polynomial is factor of that another polynomial or not, we need to find the remainder. If the remainder comes out to be zero, then the factor, then it is a factor. If remainder is not equal to zero, it is not the factor. Converse is also true. Converse ka kya matlab hai? कि अगर आपके पास एक पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स है, उसके लिए पी ऑफ फोर जीरो आ गया. इफ देर इज ए पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स, दैट मींस पॉलिनोमियल इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्स, एंड उस पॉलिनोमियल के लिए आपके पास पी ऑफ फोर जो है दैट टर्म्स आउट टू बी जीरो, तो वहां से आपको इस पॉलिनोमियल का एक जो है फैक्टर मिल जाएगा. कैसे लिखोगे आप फैक्टर? जो भी आपके पास पॉलिनोमियल का वेरिएबल है पहले वो लिखा एक्स, जो भी नंबर अंदर पुट करके जीरो आया ऑपोजिट साइन कर दो उसका, प्लस फोर है तो माइनस फोर. तो यहां से आपको फैक्टर क्या मिला? एक्स माइनस फोर. मान लो देर इज ए पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स एंड पी ऑफ माइनस थ्री हमारे पास जीरो आ गया. पॉलिनोमियल पी एक्स है उसके लिए Am I audible? Okay. चलिए. So if for a polynomial Px p of minus three equal to zero, तो polynomial क्योंकि x में है, suppose polynomial y में हो, तो हम यहां से एक factor generate कर सकते हैं. We can generate one factor from here. कैसे generate करेंगे factor? This is y, minus three का sign उल्टा कर दो, plus three. This is the factor of dy, right? So y plus 3, this is the factor of dy. So iska matlab ye hua, factor theorem is indirectly application of remainder theorem. If we have to check the factor, then again need to find remainder. And if we have to make the factor, again we need the remainder to be equal to zero. So factor theorem is linked to remainder theorem in this way, as I explained it in front of you. Right? चलिए. See one question. Check whether seven plus three x is factor of seven plus three x is factor of three x cube plus seven x or not. Naturally, जिसकी डिग्री कम है उसको फैक्टर चेक करना होता है, और जिसकी डिग्री ज्यादा है उसका फैक्टर है या नहीं ये चेक करना होता है. सो इसकी डिग्री कम है इसका मतलब इसको हमें फैक्टर चेक करना है, इसकी डिग्री ज्यादा है इसका मतलब इसका फैक्टर है या नहीं ये चेक करना है. When we will say this is factor of this, if we find remainder and remainder is equal to zero, then it will become factor of the polynomial, and if the remainder is not equal to zero, this will not be the factor of the given polynomial. So I am putting it to be equal to zero. x is equal to minus 7 by 3. Therefore, हमें फैक्टर चेक करना है, उसके लिए रिमाइंडर पहले इसका नाम रखो, जिसका फैक्टर चेक करना है उसका नाम रख लो 3x³ + 7x. सो रिमाइंडर दिस इज इक्वल टू पी ऑफ माइनस 7/3. इन प्लेस ऑफ x पुट माइनस 7/3. This is minus 343 upon 9 minus 49 upon 3. So taking the LCM, 9 will be the LCM. This will be 0, so this 7 + 3x is not factored out. So we'll continue tomorrow. Do send your notebooks according to the schedule.